Hi everyone, welcome back. So let's talk about some more interview questions which you may expect from the interviewer for the Node.js. So the first thing is they try to dig into you about your understanding on callback and promises. So we'll try to see the difference because from the code we already know that promises are some piece of code which we put in some asynchronous function which returns the object once your asynchronous API has done its task. So callback is just a block of code which runs in a response to the event. So it's like in a callback, is just like a function which we are passing from another function. So we are like passing that callback function as an argument. So callbacks are just a functions and the promises are the object which store information about whether or not those events has happened yet. So in the promises, we have to wait that particular operation has happened or not. A simple example is this. So callback are defined independently of the functions. They are called from and they are passed in as an argument. Okay. Promises like this. So there can be another function. Get API data, and here you will be returning this promise. And here might be some data. Okay, so promises are created inside the synchronous functions. Those which might not return a response until later. It means, so they need to wait. Here we might be firing some HTTP call to some API. Okay, and then once we have decided, we will be returning this promise. Okay. Callback handles success and failure. Promises do not handle anything. So promise have this concept of resolve and reject, which defines in the function when we write a promise, then we can decide when to reject a promise and when to resolve a promise. So another difference is the callback can be called multiple times by functions they are passed to, but promises can only present a one event. So you can bind one HTTP call to a single promise. Okay, so these are just code differences which you might face, like I can explain more about the promises. Like here we are returning the new promise object, and this promise object is having the resolve and reject. So either you can resolve this promise or either you can reject this promise. So here I'm rejecting this promise. So resolving this promise. Similarly, you can reject the promise. So you will be waiting. So this chunk of code will need to wait until unless you have some data from the API. This is why we use the promises. Okay, I think that's it about this.